is, bitch.
I am healthy, I am wealthy, I am rich, I am that bitch, yeah. I am gonna go get that bag and I am not gonna take your shit. I am protected, well respected, I'm a queen, I'm a dream, yeah. I do what I wanna do and I'm who I wanna be. Cause I
1, 2, 3,
fuck it.
My darling, I love you, 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 I love you.
Let's talk about the difference between deity work and deity worship. So a huge, huge, huge thing in paganism is the idea of giving and receiving. Giving and receiving is a cycle that goes on in the universe, and when we work or worship with deities, the difference lies in who's doing the most giving and who's doing the most receiving. In deity work, we form a close working relationship with the deity so that they can help us to spiritually evolve. Because they're sacrificing their own time and effort to help us so closely, they are expecting us to take out our time and our effort and make some sacrifices for them. So there's more responsibility and more time involved in deity work. In deity worship, you pray, you adore, you give offerings to a deity, not because you are expecting them to help you one-on-one, but instead because being close to the divine is just naturally good for the soul. You have a little more control in that relationship.
All right, let's talk deity work, because apparently that is a hot topic on this platform, and I want to nip some little false information in the ass right now. First of all, if you want to be a witch, you don't have to work with a deity. Like, witchcraft does not mean deity work or spirit work. You don't have to work with any spirits or any deities if you don't want to. And on the flip side of that, not every petition that you make, whether it's to like a deity or a spirit, is going to be answered. You won't always work with a deity that you want to or a spirit that you want to, because, you know, they can say no. While I'm so grateful for all the deities that I've worked with, it can cause burnout so bad. I remember not touching my tarot deck for a couple of weeks and not doing anything like magical because of how burnt out I was, like just from putting my all into like this one lesson that I need to learn. Also, half the shit you see on Witchtok about deity work is dramatized for views.
Yeah, I'm just starting. I don't really have a deity yet, and I don't want to do that because I know that it's a lot of responsibility, and it's not a joke to just, you know, join something like that. No. I just started last week, and I have 95 deities. You have what? How do you make time for 95 deities? What do you mean, how do I make time for them? They come to me when they want something. I'm their master. How did you find them? I went on Yahoo Answers and WikiHow. How else would I find them?
Can I make a huge reminder towards baby and closeted witches? You don't have to have money or a lot of money or approval from family to do work. Especially since I talk about working with deities, you don't have to have a lot to work with a deity. Dollar Tree, Walmart, and regular stores are really good options. And when working with a deity, they understand. They don't care how much money you spend on them. They don't care how much incense and herbs you buy for them. They care about the fact that you do what you can, and you apologize if you wish you could do more, but you do what you can, and you're respectful to them. You don't use things that are offensive to them, and you put in the time and effort to work with them. That is what deities care about. So I promise, if you don't have the right candle, the right incense, or the right herbs, it's okay. You're still loved and welcomed by almost all deities.
I have a genuine question, and I don't know how to ask it. But I'm gonna try and probably offend someone anyways. I'm confused as to why there are certain deities that you can't work with because it's insulting to some sort of belief or people or culture. I'm having a hard time understanding why it's any different than someone being like, you can't be friends with that person because you're not the same color as them. this makes me mad because if I decide that I want to work with deities, I don't know who I'm supposed to work with. I don't know my ancestors. Without buying a DNA test, I don't even know where I descend from. Like, my family doesn't have a lot of knowledge about that. I just know that I'm a pasty bitch, and that's still not very helpful. So, like, I don't want to offend anyone, but I just genuinely don't understand. There's a lot of deities that I think are really cool and really interesting, and I feel like they would be fun to work with. But at the same time, I'm watching this girl who might not even be 18 get eaten alive by the public for working with Lilith.
Okay, so God is here, and he has a bone to pick. With people.
Stop calling me Sky Daddy, I swear to me. I'm not a whore. What the hell, I don't get it. What are y'all on, my lord?
You're not a whore.
I don't even like people like that. It's gross and nasty. I'm not into that stuff.
Are you done?
Yes.
Call him Sky Daddy.
I'm gonna smite you.
I love that people think Jesus is kind of like,
I am holier than thou, use old language, very flowy, very old. I know nothing of new and only go by the Bible. I'm old.
Bruh, I know shit sucks absolute monkey dicks, but trust your friends for once? Please?
Okay, that's fair.
Compramos carros y camionetas viejas para desarmar.
A lot of people ask me how I communicate with my deities. And oftentimes I do meditation, or I turn my medium abilities up in order to receive messages from them. But if you are not a medium or you have difficulty with your psychic clairs, this is another method. I have Freya's candle and one of her favorite stones, and we're gonna light it and then use her specified deck to commune with her. So I basically placed her stone on top of her tarot deck, and I'm just gonna sit for a minute and set my intentions. And then we just read the cards. I have Ace of Pentacles, King of Cups reversed, Ace of Cups reversed, Six of Pentacles reversed, Five of Pentacles reversed. So the amount of pentacles, I would say that there's a lack of grounding, which I haven't grounded in a couple days, so I'm being called out for that, and a lack of focusing on my emotions, and behind on shadow work.
How interactions with deities go for me? A few days ago with Hermes and Hades. I'm having a terrible day. My views on TikTok are awful and I'm going to be late for work. Hermes, if you get me to work on time, I'll give you
ice cream.
Ice cream? What kind? Fudge chocolate peanut butter brownie. Okie dokie. You're going to be late. Take the crystals I tell you to and go. Speeds the whole way with no holdups in traffic. Finds a perfect spot, then makes eye contact with a pit bull wearing a pink cowboy hat riding shotgun in a truck passing by. Oh my gods. You're welcome.
Things I have offered to my deities, except it makes less and less sense to non-pagans. Clippings from various animals that they have patronage over. A statue of them. A candle in their honor. Pieces of insects or dead insects. Objects I found outside, like tree bark. Animal bones in animal sheds. Wine and other hard liquors. Specific crystals and herbs that they have associations with. Random rocks that I found outside that I felt like they would like. Meals in their honor. Seeds. Cookies like Oreos. Gummy worms. Raisinettes. Coffee.
Money. Me doing my job and working in their honor.
A very specific outfit that I cater to them. Snake candle holders.
One question I get a lot is, what happens to deity offerings when you give it to them? So let's go over that. So when you put something on their altar, like a object or a crystal or a toy or something like that, that's something that they can mess with in the physical plane, so they can like admire it here. But food and drinks are basically going to be something that they access in the astral. It won't disappear, it'll still be there, but the energy that it has is going to be taken to the astral plane. So obviously your next questions are like, when do I know they're done with it, and how do I dispose of it? Usually you'll know, I usually leave my offerings out for like, you know, 6 to 12 hours or whatever, like sometimes even overnight. It kind of just depends on how lazy I am. If it's food, I'll ask if they're done with it and if I can consume it afterwards. Usually they'll say yes, or I'll just, you know, give it to nature. Especially if it's like coffee for Lucifer or tea for Loki or Sununus, I'll just put it outside and like dump it outside so that the earth can take it. It's practitioner's preference for that.
Hey,
Hamburger Gabble.
What? After all you put me through, you expect me to help you just like that? Just like that? Fine.
Fine? You're doing what he says.
He's very persuasive.
This is part one of how I have so many entities that I work with and a little bit of my worship for them. I started my morning by veiling before I approach my altar and lighting all of my pagan deities' candles. They're all burning down pretty low. I do have a new candle order coming that I'm waiting for. Here all of them are. I have my tarot cards ready for my first reading. I get some coffee, and I had time to get dressed before my first reading this morning. If I wake up with dreams, I write them down in my dream journal, and I did a lot of shadow work last night with the help of one of my entities. You can see all of it here. And yeah, this is part one of this series.
Let's make Hades a new candle. The first thing I do after cleansing, of course, is carve a sigil for him. Then I have a very special herb mix he likes. Mix. Finished look of herb mix. Now oil. I put a very light layer of oil around the whole candle. Then lightly cover in herbs and allow to dry. Blessed be from Hades and me.
Aphrodite, I promise I will stop talking shit about my own body. Please stop being mad at me. Please don't be mad at me. I'm sorry. I love myself. Self-love. My body's amazing. It's beautiful. Please calm down. I'm so sorry.
What was your biggest oh shit moment with a deity?
When I first started my craft, I was really into Aphrodite, and I had a little honor altar set up for her, and one of my offerings for her was this lip gloss, and it was really cool, and she liked it. So my sister decided to grab the lip gloss without me knowing from the altar. She woke up the next day with acne all over her face, and it was bad, and Aphrodite was not happy.
New tarot, I have an urgent message. Oh, must be serious, okay. It just says go to bed. Yes.
Witchtok, stitch this and tell me the craziest thing that a deity did that you were not expecting. I'll go first. When I very first started working with the Morrigan, and she literally got me out of my horrible abusive relationship that I was in, and then I was still stuck in California because, like, I had this job and I was trying to get a job in Minnesota so I could move back, and I, like, she was literally like, okay, like, just, like, come on, like, let's go, like, we're moving on. And I was like, well, I can't do anything because I have this job. And I literally, she was like, okay, fine. And I swear to God, I got laid off the next day. Laid off. It was just that I could just, like, feel her in the back of my mind being like, okay, like, you don't have a job now, so let's go.